Good morning, it's Friday. We are on our way to the Louvre. I heard it was something that you have to do over 3 or 4 days, but we're gonna be doing it over a morning. So whatever we get done, we get done. Yesterday we did Normandy, Pointe de Hoc, did the cemetery, went out for a nice little dinner, took the metro there. We're getting actually pretty good at the metro. If you've ever been to the Louvre, you obviously know how large this place is. Absolutely crazy size. All right, so we are about to wait on the long line until this beautiful woman right here found out that the city pass completely skips the line. So we completely skipped the line, and now we're in.
Ooh, going to see the Mona Lisa. The most famous painting in the world, for I have no idea why.
The chaos that is the Mona Lisa. Humanity at its finest. How are you expecting the Mona Lisa to look?
I did read about it, and I really thought it was going to be a very large painting. As I've been reading, it turns out it's very small. So I have a feeling that there's about 60 pair of eyes looking at the same time that why this pair of eyes squeezed through to see.
Yeah.
At least I can say
I saw it.
The frame of the Mona Lisa.
Exactly.
I saw her forehead.
We are now in the middle of the Mona Lisa crowd. Yeah. Mom, how do you feel?
How are we going to get out?
Oh, yeah. Oh, flights are occurring. Flights are occurring. Here we go. My mom wants to get in. She wants to do front row. Dad, how does it feel? My dad wants to go out. He's like, he doesn't know why. The reason that the Mona Lisa has such a following and why it's the most visited painting in the world is because it's mass acceptance and mass agreement that it is the most priceless work of art out there. I don't know if it is, but it's the agreement. No one actually said this is it, but such mass acceptance has said this is the most priceless work, the most visited artwork in the world, and everyone just accepted it. You know, just like the world, we accepted that the world was flat until we turned out the world is round. One thing that I would recommend going to the Louvre is pick a spot, stay there, dissect it, move on to another spot, dissect it, because there's a lot of areas where you can't go back through. So when you go into a spot, choose it. Like I like the Roman era. I clearly have an audio guide on right now, and it's not even enough because the audio guides go on for about 4 minutes each. And if you do that for each place throughout, you're never gonna see what you want. So I would recommend just choosing a spot, sticking to that, then moving on instead of skimming through, because I see too many people just like, oh, okay. And they're seeing a lot, but they don't know anything about what they're seeing. These are taken from the top parts of a building, I'm assuming. And we'll just zoom in on one area. We'll zoom in on this guy. And you're looking at this, there's absolutely no chisel marks. It's smooth. And you're wondering, how did you do this thousands of years ago, or even if it's 1500 years ago, 2000 years ago, whatever, how did you make this piece so intricate to the fact that you could put it on top of a building, and they knew that it was going on top of a building. They knew it was going on top of a building, and they still made it intricate. That is what is exciting to me. This is what I was talking about, is that at the top, you'll have these blocks that are intricately made Corinthian pillars that support this structure at a time that you're like, how did you get it up there? How'd you get it up to the top? And then it was sculpted. Each block of marble was sculpted on the ground. How long did that take out of a single piece of marble? So we look at it and we're like, oh, that's beautiful. But then if you look at each inch, they smoothed it down and then they built out faces and emperors and gods and goddesses. And then they put it up on top of this building. And what I was looking at before is just a little sliver of the top. What's even funnier, the people that are behind the sculpture, completely ruining it, like them and them and them. Yeah,
Look at everyone just trying to take a photo. But unfortunately, these people are clueless that we're not, yeah, you're looking at the wrong side. You gotta be looking at this side.
So I was on my way to the medieval portion of the Louvre when I stumbled upon audio set triggered the history of the Louvre, which is actually not built as a museum. It wasn't built as a house. It was built as a fortress, which we're actually walking in the moat part of it. It was built on the right side of the river because that's where the wealthy lived, and it was built as a fortress to protect against the English, their arch rival. All right, so I just got done with the Louvre, or we, I should say, parents and sister. Unbelievable place, you gotta go. Obviously, being that I'm from New York, we have all these museums. This one is like none other, with the original art pieces, the history, the audio tour was incredible. We're now walking to do the hop on, hop off bus. But the ironic part is that you have to go to one specialized place to pick up the ticket, which is completely out of the way and not on one of the routes. You can't buy it on the bus, you can't buy it at one of the stops, you have to go to a centralized place. So that's where we're walking right now. All right, we picked up the tickets, a little out of the way, not a big deal. I'm going to pick up mom and dad. Kerry's going to get some water for everyone. It's not that bad today. It's probably in the 80s, low humidity, which is amazing. If it was high humidity, not that fun. All right, so picking them up, we're gonna do the hop on, hop off, tell you guys how that is. And then we're actually gonna do the canal cruise tonight. So I'm looking forward to that. Welcome to Paris. The best thing to do is get the pass that will skip the line. We just skipped the Louvre line and we just skipped the arch line as well, and we are about to go up there. Okay, so we just started up. I thought there was a lift, and then you walk 47, 48 stairs, but that is not the case. We've made it to the top of the Arch de du Triomphe, which is for the unknown soldier. Even Adolf Hitler, when he came through here in 1940, did not go under the arch in respect for the unknown. Here is the part of France, Paris, that you don't really hear about. Just this wild financial district, kind of tall commercial buildings. Leaving the Arch du Triomphe, and we are now gonna be going to the Eiffel Tower. Never heard of that, huh? All right, so we are on the tour bus, which I always used to make fun of in New York City, and now I did an entire loop on one of them, and we just transferred, and we're gonna be going on another one. This one right here convinced me to take one in New York City. All right, just finished the hop on, hop off.
I don't think we hopped off and just never got back on.
Yeah. Kerry lost her glasses.
Sans glasses.
This is like Chucky live.
Yeah. This is the second to last night at Cars Bar, Paris,
Paris, France. Tim and Lindsay Meyer from Washington, D.C. We're here with our best buddy.
What would you say about your children? Who's your favorite?
Our favorite child would have to be
Chucky.
That's our favorite.